aquaponics do over take 11. Welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. So I've gone through several videos. I'm gonna have over 20 odd videos. Talking about my aquaponic setup. I'm talking about the pump. I'm talking about, you know, splitting the piping, talking about how I got the plant up there. I talk about my lettuce. You're asking me. Well, probably you're asking yourself, hey, so what about the all those lettuce signature I saw the last time? Okay, so if you remember, it's kind of like a dead, right? I don't know what's going on. All right, if you can remember, my last video I shared with you, I sprayed my lettuce with vinegar, right? And I shared with you the subsequent video after that, that they all dried up, burnt up. And some persons might say, hey, but you're stupid because you should have known that that would have happened. Well, you know, it's a learning process, and if we don't actually do certain things visually, some persons will never understand why you don't do certain things, right? So that said, all this is died. I had to take them out. I tried cutting them to see if they would respring to give me some leaf, and this is what I got. All of them actually died. Alright, so I went, and I'm not going to be showing you another 10-15 videos before I actually show the lettuce. These are just some of the plants that I'm showing you now that are coming up. I've planted a few other crops in it. I could not get lettuce, so I got some other crops. Not even gonna be mentioning them what I got, but they are here, and if they do come, I can tell you, right? Because I plant cabbage and they never come, and I'm gonna be sharing with you that in a bit. So my lettuce bed is being replanted, and the next video you see on this, you will see my lettuce back to the same size that they were when I actually sprayed them with the vinegar and destroyed them. Right, yeah, I should have added water into the mix. All right, so here I am over by planter bed number 2 for my aquaponic system. And guys, you notice something? Yeah, it is not a planter bed wherein I touch the top and it sinks like the last time. I've done a lot of work on it, right? It's not like how it was before, because I have actually done some homework. Why is this rock is a good rock to be in your aquaponic system? It should not be the only rock within your aquaponic system. So what I did was to practically fill the planter bed up to the hole that actually returns the water, with rocks, you know, construction gravel rocks. Right, so it's all, yeah, so these rocks are all laid out up to that point in which the water will actually return. And after I've actually done that, I actually placed this rock type at the top. Right, it's light, it's floatable, but at the same time it should allow for the plants to grow and grow very nicely. Right, so I'm not looking at the possibility. I'm no longer looking at the possibility of the plants actually, well, the seeds actually, I call it rotting or rot in the water, the soupy like water that existed before, right? So all I needed to do was to just shift the space, and I just drop a seed in, and the seed should come because it's at a particular level, right? So the water is not like having the rocks floating, right? I did a lot of work here off camera because I think it was, you know, based on a lot of errors that I made, that situation just never played out properly in this planter bed. This planter bed going on okay. Everything is just good, right? But this was like a sewer because nothing would grow in here. All the waste was coming from the pond to here, nothing would go in here, so a lot of stinky waste was here, just floating, and I had to do something about that, and it's been corrected. So you have the construction rock at the base, right, and you have some amount of water with nutrients in it there. I just did some planting, so you won't see it until February. Well, this video is done, it's been done like a few months before it's shown, so the next video in this space, I might just show you some of the crops coming up, some of the lettuce coming up. The cabbage all died, so I might just show you what's coming up next. I'm gonna be replanting the lettuce, but I need to see at least a few lettuce do come. I planted some amount of crops here the other day, about 2 days ago, right? It's not surprising that they are not up as yet, but we'll see what happened. But I am not losing, I'm not feeling daunted, because I know that all of this is a learning experience. Now, persons might ask, why is it that I did not just, you know, use a manual from one of those aquaponics thing that they have on the internet, or, you know, on YouTube. But, you know, it's good when you can make mistakes and you can actually learn from them, and you can actually improve on some of the steps that were made by others. And sometimes person says certain things and you're wondering why did they say that. Not to say that you're gonna, you know, you're gonna go against what they say, but at least you see the proof in the pudding to say, oh, that's the reason why. So you always hear they say that do not spray vinegar on your vegetables, it will destroy them. And you're wondering why, what will happen if you don't dilute it. Well, my last video actually shared with you what will happen. This video, I'm actually doing an entire replanting, an entire reset up. Pump is still working good. You saw in one of my previous videos where the pump actually stopped working because Impala you know, just broke. I share a video as to how I dealt with that, and I could have actually tell you beforehand that was going to happen because of the sound that I heard from the Impala when I first placed it in, because too much pressure was being pushed out, but it was being gauged by this thing here. All right, so enough talking. Pitch is going okay. I had to do a lot of water change. Probably about 60% water change this morning, because, you know, with all the mess being stored in this and all the lettuce dying, you find that a lot of the nutrients are now just sitting into the planter bed, not going anywhere, and after a while the planter bed starts to flood because there's excessive nutrients or waste building up in the planter bed, so therefore it flows back in. And with the feed itself not being of good quality, you find that the fish were like gapping at the top of the pond. And that was a clear indication that, listen, I needed to change some water and I need to change it right now. If I did not do that, all my fish would have died and everything would have crashed. I hope that this going around the bush about what I did serve you well. Have a wonderful day, guys. You may have a lot of work to do. And there's a lot of wasps around here. So, peace out. Catch you next time. Bye-bye.